I'm Mike, how are you?
Sure.
This is my brother.
See you wear, they're very light, they won't throw you off. Anybody interested? Okay.
Can I hold, you know, I'll hold it.
Well, this way you're free.
I'm free to make the noise.
We had no idea how many people were going to show up. We just sent out the word far and wide, and we asked everybody to tell everybody they know.
And your route starts from right here at the McDonough Monument.
Right, after the speakers, and we'll go across the bridge, then back, City Hall, up Margaret, around to Stupanics, and then back here, those of us that still have any stamina.
My kids might want to do this one.
Oh, that's fun. Maybe if we set it out, like.
We have to believe that we can create change, and not only believe, but act on these ambitions. To quote Gandhi, be the change you wish to see in the world.
It's arguable that in the absence of good governance, the biggest enemy of dealing with climate change is public indifference. And that's why it's so important that you're all here today. You may not realize it, but one branch of the government that's particularly interested in this kind of movement is the judiciary. Most people do not realize it, but judges can make laws more quickly and more effectively than legislators can. That's happening right now with this, with the children's climate movement. In fact, there was a decision in Washington State recently. A judge said that the government should be protecting the environmental resources that are required by present and future generations' survival. That's a fundamental responsibility of representative government. It's absolutely basic. And that's the field of natural trust law, which is something that you're going to hear a lot more about in the near future. However, judges have to see this kind of public support before they're going to engage in that kind of radical lawmaking. That's why what you're doing here today is so very important. And there's legislation too, of course. That's what we usually think of when we think about movements, is getting our legislators to do something. And I share the desire of people like Jim Hansen, Elon Musk, George Shultz, and most other economists on both sides of the political aisle to see the institution of a fee on carbon fuels. This would be a fee that would be levied at the point where carbon fuel enters the economy, at the port, the wellhead, or the mine. It would reflect the cost of environmental damage done by the use of these fuels. The only reason that fossil fuel energy is so cheap is because we don't pay the cost of the damage that's done. It's not included in the price. It's inexpensive energy because the atmosphere, the oceans, and our bodies are basically the sewers where this pollution can be dumped. Therefore, we need to include the environmental cost in the price of such fuels. In addition, we need to then take that revenue that comes from such a fee and return it to the citizens of the United States in equal shares. Just put it back into their bank accounts, back on debit cards, make electronic deposits. Such a fee and dividend system raises the price of using carbon fuels, which drives market forces that will begin to transform our economy. Returning the proceeds in this way will ensure that poor and middle class income people receive more in their dividends than they have to spend paying the higher cost of carbon fuels. Moreover, that will generate the political will that is so essential to making this transformation come about.